Man, listen, from hating ass coworkers to a banging ass opening, which I don't understand how people hate on this, but who gives a shit, to perfect chemistry between three people who have just met. Spy Family Episode 2 was an absolute blast, bro, because not only did we get introduced to a newer character in Yor, who I was waiting on meeting, right? I was waiting on meeting Yor because she is a fascinating character. She is gorgeous. She is an assassin. And there were some points in this episode where I was wondering, like, is she airheaded or is she just really good at concealing, like, her thoughts and playing a role? Because, bro, can you not tell he's a spy? That's neither here nor there. I really can't wait to experience the Lloyd, Yor, and Anya moments, bro. I think these shits are going to be priceless. We already got a glimpse, right? We already had a glimpse when they were at the tailor, and that was, like, their low-key first introduction. And there's just way more to come, bro. But before we get into any further detail, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Damo Senpai, and we are here to discuss episode 2 of Spy Family. If you are new to the channel and have yet to subscribe, make sure you go down below, hit the link in the description or the red subscribe button. Either want to help me towards that cause of reaching my goal, which is to become a full-time content creator. The Patreon is almost set up, so if you guys want to be a part of something bigger than what this seems on the surface, we'll have a whole separate video for that purpose as the days go on. So episode 2 started off with a fucking banger. I don't understand how people on Twitter, because I was on Twitter earlier, right? I was on Twitter before the episode dropped, and people were saying that the OP wasn't good, that it didn't slap, that it wasn't, like, strong enough to start. Well, I hate to be the bearer of good news, but it started off just like I thought it would. Think about it like this. We are dealing with a spy, an assassin, and an esper. You're not getting some super crazy, ridiculous rock song, bro. Like, no, that's not happening. This opening fits what this anime is and what we got from the first episode and the vibes that were already set, you know, the mood and everything that was already set. It's literally that. It's a smooth ass anime with a little bit of pizzazz on top, bro. I don't get what people were saying, but anyway, that's neither here nor there. Frankie killed it, bro. Frankie killed it. He dressed up in female attire, and obviously Lloyd was just bullshitting, and Anya was having a fucking field day with Frankie, bro. That shit was super awesome. And then we get into the whole Yor ordeal. Her co-workers ain't shit. And I'm glad at the end, Camilla, if that's what her name is, Camilla got her just desserts. But dude, she is an asshole. Hating on Yor the whole time. She was like, oh, you know, you got a great figure, this, that, and the third. You should have a husband right now. Oh, by the way, might want to get somebody because they're getting people out of here for being so suspicious, you know, not having any significant other and being 27 and up. And bro, that whole shit was just messy. These co-workers are the ideal messy. And then we end up getting to see Yor in her assassin motif, right? You see the shift. There was a quick ass shift from Yor the airheaded, like, attendant to Yor the assassin. When she was talking on the phone to her brother, you know, she was being all regular and, you know, having a good conversation, just to quickly flip because she thought her brother was calling her back, to the boss calling and her going in high heels and all and just taking out this whole group of people. Bro, cold-blooded, bro. Ultra cold-blooded. The only time she showed emotion was because of her dress. It got ripped and she had to go get it tailored, which led to the fated meeting between Yor, Anya, and Lloyd. Dude, when I tell you Anya was the true MVP, as soon as Lloyd heard that her name was Yor, he immediately went into, like, fucking super spy detective mode, sifted through every single one of the fucking applications in his brain just to be swooned by the wonderful Yor. And he already knew what the deal was too. He already knew it was fate. Bro, she slipped in right behind his senses, bro. He thought that he was being too loose. He thought he was being a little too careless, saying that, you know, he wasn't up to par as of late. But nah, bro, that's just the fucking movements of an assassin. And as you know, they're having this whole little like debacle between each other. It's like talking to each other without talking to each other to get their points across. And Anya, of course, being the mediator, like the middleman, she is gold. Every time she is around, it's gold. Lloyd was considering her as a candidate to play the wife, but then he was like, nah, fuck that, because something seems off. And Anya was reading his mind. Anytime you see the sparkles, that's when Anya's reading the mind. And then Yor was just like, I was considering him to act as my boyfriend at the party, but I gotta avoid these type of like weird lover quarrel type things. Bro, here comes fucking Anya with, this is like Kron style acting, bro. I am so lonely because I don't have a mom. Bro, that shit killed me, dude. That shit killed me. And then, like I said, that led to the fated meeting and them coming to the conclusion like, yeah, you know, we can sort of do this thing. That leads to the party invitation and, you know, them just finally getting things together. But then he has to go on a mission, bro. Meanwhile, Yor is over here in the fucking freezing cold, snot dribbling down her nose, waiting on this motherfucker to come pick her up and shit. Which leads to the party, which leads to the hating ass co-workers talking mad shit. It was so much hating going on, bro. Just to go to the party, just to get made fun of, and they talking shit, and your first like thought is like, man, it wouldn't be a problem if they all just randomly disappeared. I was like, whoa, Yor, slow your roll, hold your horses. You don't want to go out on a killing spree just to end up probably being hunted down by the one and only Lloyd, aka Twilight. Could have potentially been something, but that's neither here nor there. And then, bro, not to mention how quickly, what is her name, Camilla, super hated when Lloyd was like, oh yeah, I'm here to pick up my wife and, you know, all that other shit. She was super hating, tried to fucking spill some hot shrimp dish, bro. Oh man, just to see yours quick reflexes, lightning fast reflexes, kick that, not only kick it, she caught it before she kicked it and then kicked that bitch up, bro. So tight. Again, I think these two are a match made in heaven. And then you add Anya into the mix, bro, and I think this is literally gonna be the best show this season, for the spring season, bro. I will say that with confidence. Other than like Tomodachi Game and shit like that, and maybe Shikamori, I can't really see anything beating this, bro. I'm so looking forward to the next episode because I think they're going to the school, right? I think they're going to the school because Yor is moving in, and man, like I said earlier, bro, this anime is legit like a roller coaster ride. It's gonna make you feel all sorts of things. You're gonna be happy, sad, excited, all that stuff. And then at the end of the day, you're gonna feel good, right? You feel good going in, you feel good going out. I really have high hopes for Spy Family, and I can't wait to see where this shit goes. Anyways, let me know what you thought about this episode. Let me know what you thought about the job Cloverworks did. Were you surprised? Were you baffled? Let me know down below. Also, if there's anything else you guys wanna see from your boy, make sure y'all let me know in the comment section as well. Leave a like if you enjoy, subscribe if you're new, videos every day. And with that being said, it's your boy, Damo Senpai, and I will see you guys in the next video.